Hi, my name is Bret McGowen, and I'm a software developer here at Rackspace, and I work on the Rack Connect project. So today we're going to talk a little about password security. You may have seen in the news over the past few months and years, some companies have gotten into trouble for their password security. So we're going to talk about, for your app, what is a good approach to take? So a couple of things to note, a lot of people want to put encryption on their passwords. And so we'll talk a little bit about what is the difference between encryption and hashing your passwords and why encryption is probably a bad idea. So let's kind of talk about conceptually what the difference is. So for encryption, that is like a safe, right? So here is your safe. And if you know the password and you know the combination, you can get into that safe. So that's where you want to put something like credit card information, potentially, stuff that you have to be able to read back out as is. Now we can talk about hashing. So hashing is a little bit different in that is what we call a one-way function. So the analogy I've heard that I kind of like, it's like if you put a cow through a machine and you get a hamburger, right? You cannot put that hamburger back into that cow. And if you had the perfect machine, every time you put the same cow through, you would get the same hamburger. So that's kind of what hashing is like. It sort of fingerprints your password. But from your fingerprint, you can't recreate the original password. So even if a hacker gets your database, just by looking at the hash of the password, they can't actually get the password out of it. So the idea there is, when someone logs in, what you do is you actually take their password, you run it through the hash, you get that hash value, you compare what's in the database, and if those two values match, then you know the password is good. So that's how you can compare their password and check it without actually knowing what their password is, without saving it anywhere. So that brings up a little bit of another issue though, which is if a hacker gets your database and they have a list of all the hash passwords in there, there are a couple of tricks that they've figured out, and one of these is called rainbow tables or pre-computing tables. And what they'll do is they will actually take all the words in the dictionary, all the words from one letter all the way up to 12 letters or 16 letters, and they will take common hashes, so MD5 or SHA, and they will pre-hash all the possible combinations of passwords that exist. So then what they do is they look in their huge mega list, and then they go look for your hashed password value in the database, and if they find a match, then they know what the password is. So to get around that, to make it so hackers can't do that, we'll introduce something called a salt. And essentially all a salt is that is going to be a random sequence of characters. So let's say like 128 characters. And when the user creates their password, you'll just randomly create a 128 character string. Then you'll take the salt, attach the password to it, and you will hash this whole string. So now you actually have a much longer password, and then you'll take this value, and to that you will add the salt just in plain text, and usually with some kind of delimiter, so like a colon, and then you'll add that to the hash. So in the database, it'll say salt, colon, and then the hashed salt plus password value. So now, because you have a different salt for every user in the database, a hacker can't pre-compute what all those values would be. And so that's pretty much a good way to ensure that when a hacker gets a database, like, they can't get all your passwords. If they kept at it long enough, maybe they could get one user's password, but they are not going to compromise the whole database. So an important thing to know here, though, this salt needs to be unique per user, because if you just have the same salt for every password in the database, if the hacker gets their hands on that salt, it's the same as if they're getting the encryption key to the safe, which means they can unlock all the passwords in the database. So that, in a nutshell, is hashing. If you're looking for a good hashing algorithm, there are some out there, one in particular called bcrypt, that is recommended, because it's actually kind of a slow encryption algorithm. And that's good, because if a hacker is trying to recreate the hash on your password, you actually want that to be really slow, because it'll take maybe, you know, a tiny bit extra when the user logs in, but they'll never notice that. For a hacker who's trying to do thousands and millions of hashes, this is going to take them a lot longer. That's Password Security. Thanks for watching. I'm Bret McGowen. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments, and I'll catch you next time.